Saturn delays but never denies. Is it true or is it a myth? Does he never deny or does he always deny or does he only delay? What is it? Saturn. There's a very big question which is asked that I feel Saturn denies sometimes. Sometimes he doesn't deny. So what exactly happens? All right, so it's back to Saturn again. So why does this question come when it comes to Saturn only? You'll never hear somebody saying, does Rahu denies or he just delays, right? But even with benefics or with Sun, Mars, any other malefic also, why only with Saturn? Because Saturn can delay for a very long time sometimes. So you have to understand certain things when it comes to Saturn. It's very important. Your Saturn is good or bad, that result will be seen in two places: overall in your life, of course, and primarily, specifically during the Antardasha or the Mahadasha of Saturn. When can you feel it more? It's primarily in the Antardashas I've seen. Now, what does Saturn represent? Saturn represents those things which you can cross over, but it comes with a tagline. Tagline means you have to pay a price when it comes to Saturn. It doesn't come for free, or nothing comes for free, but for Saturn, it doesn't come very easily. You have to pay a heavy price. So, therefore, if you have Saturn in 10th house and your dasha gets activated, and you have Jupiter in 10th, that person's Jupiter gets activated, the 10th house is getting activated. The same thing will happen. But what is the difference? The difference is how much effort do you need to put to either get that or maintain that? It's either ways. So sometimes people think that if they have Saturn in 7th or maybe in the 2nd or 11th, then it's difficult to get married. It gets delayed. But what if in your 20s you are running, suppose, Venus Mahadasha, and you are running Rahu Antardasha from the age of 25 to 28? What about then? And then 28 to 30, 31, you are running maybe next of Rahu, which is Jupiter. So maybe these three planets, Jupiter, Rahu, and Venus, they are very well linked with the houses of marriage. Then, even if you have Saturn in 7th, there won't be any delay. So now you understand the so-called secret, why people say that. Because many times you'll see people telling, oh, Saturn is in 7th house, my marriage will be delayed. But then sometimes you see marriage happens in India around 25 to 30, that 23 to around 28, that could be the standard time. After 28, you could say it's a bit delayed considering India. After 30, it's more delayed. But I have one of my seniors who has Saturn in 7th. He's a Cancer ascendant. And he got married in time. He got married at 23 or 24, I would say. 23 or 22 could be early marriage. Why? Why this has happened? Because he had dashas of other planets which are linked with the houses of marriage. So in that case, there is no delay even if Saturn is in 7th. Now, there's the catch, you see. That dasha, Mahadasha and Antardasha, gave him marriage. The event of wedding. Okay, the marriage happened. Now, finally, the person's status changed from being unmarried to married. That did not happen because of Saturn. That happened because of dashas of other planets. But now, when Saturn Antardasha starts, Saturn Antardasha will come always. You know, 5 years, may not be 5 years, but 5 years, 10 years, 15 years down the line, it always keeps coming, and the Mahadashas keep changing. Considering that the person has will be living till the age of 60, 70. So now, what happens when Saturn's Antardasha starts, and in the Bhav chart, Saturn is in the 7th house? What happens then? Yes, then there comes the challenge. So now there's no question of denial or delay because the marriage has already happened. But because now it is the dasha of Saturn and Saturn is sitting in the seventh house post marriage, there will be a lot of issues which will come up in the marriage, which will test their patience actually. But now the question is, will it lead to a bad marriage or good marriage, or how do we analyze it? Well, you have to check the sign because Saturn has its own sign. It is forming Sasha Mahapurush Yoga. Therefore, this is a very positive thing to have in the seventh house. So it will really test your commitment, how much committed you are towards the marriage. You might get some allurements. Yes, everybody talks of Rahu in seventh, alluring for marriage, not good for marriage. But even Saturn in the seventh can give you allurements. Or they can give allurements to your spouse, depending on the dashas and, if Rahu is also involved. Why do I say this? Because then there's a challenge. Can you say no to the temptation, or do you give in to it? That's the secret, you see. So in this case, although there was no denial or there was no delay, but in this case, after marriage, there can be some challenge. But now let's take another scenario when it can be denial. Now suppose Saturn is sitting in the sixth house. Now sixth house is against marriage. So now suppose you are running Saturn's Mahadasha. That in that entire Mahadasha, if it is not linked with nakshatras to the second, seventh, and 11th, provided I am seeing, then the entire 19 years, the marriage may be denied. Because marriage is one event, if the Mahadasha Lord denies, it cannot happen. Now, this is an example when the marriage can be denied. The entire Mahadasha, yes, it can happen. But suppose Saturn is in the sixth house in your bhav chart and it is in the nakshatra of the second lord or any planet sitting in the second house. Okay. So in that case, what happens? That case, it's like 50-50. The second house says yes to marriage, the sixth house says no to marriage. So in that case, there can be a delay of marriage. It can be very difficult to find somebody. Then it depends on the antardashas. If the antardashas are also signifying the sixth house or the tenth house, then marriage can be denied. But if the antardashas are signifying good houses for marriage, like second, seventh, and 11th, then the marriage can be delayed, but it could happen. So that's like a scenario. Okay, when marriage is when Saturn can deny certain things, when Saturn can delay certain things. So in the first case, I said, although Saturn is sitting in a house, but if the dashas are not coming in that time, then during that event of wedding, for example, there will be no delays, 100%. But if now let's assume this same person, Cancer ascendant, with Saturn in Capricorn in the seventh, Saturn Antardasha starts, Venus Saturn. And then there is 3 years of Venus Saturn, for example, 25 to 28. Now, in that case, what can happen? There could be some delays. But because he's sitting in the seventh house, he won't deny marriage. And in that case, the spouse may be a bit elder than this person because Saturn shows, somebody who is elder. But in this case, because this person, my senior, got married. Not in dashas related to Saturn, neither Antardasha or Mahadasha was linked. So there was no age difference between him and his wife. Okay, so therefore, you should check the Mahadasha, then you should check the Antardasha, then you should check what the horoscope is telling. So if the sixth house or the tenth house is very prominent, then chances of no marriage or divorce is very, very, very high, or celibacy in short. But suppose the second, seventh, and 11th are very prominent. Most of the planets are sitting in the nakshatras or planets sitting in these houses or the lords of these second, seventh, and 11th. Then chances of marriage is very high. So in that case, Saturn might delay, but he may not deny All right. So to make a statement, Saturn denies, but he Saturn delays, but it doesn't deny, is absolute. That doesn't make sense. It depends on the flavor of the horoscope. And to also say that Saturn will always deny, that's also not true. And we saw all the cases, you know, first case that Saturn doesn't even delay, what to speak of denying. Yes, because the planetary dashas are not linked with Saturn that time. Because sometimes people think that the planet in the seventh house can only give you marriage. No, the planet in the second and 11th can also give you marriage, because these three houses of marriage. That's the problem with people learning astrology. They don't know the concepts properly. They don't know that for one event, there are multiple houses. Same is with childbirth, the second, fifth, ninth, and 11th. All these four are houses of childbirth. So if you have Saturn in the fifth, does it mean you will never have a child? No, it's not like that. It depends on what you have in the second, ninth, and 11th. Okay. So in the second case, we saw if Saturn Antar Dasha comes, okay, and then Saturn is in seventh, then during those 3 years, it could be a bit struggle to get married because he's a malefic. So he may not deny, but he may delay it. Okay. And in third case, if the Mahadasha Lord is linked with the sixth house, or the overall horoscope is very much prominent for celibacy, then Saturn might deny that. Okay, so Saturn may delay, he may never delay, or he may also deny. All the three scenarios are possible. So it will depend on your horoscope, which one of the three is actually happening. Okay, so do not jump into a blind conclusion. Oh, Saturn is in my seventh, I'll never get married. Saturn is in my tenth, I won't ever get a promotion. What if you had, you know, a moon in the tenth along with Saturn? Then in moon dasha, you'll have promotion. In Saturn dasha also you will have, but you will have with a lot of hard work. But in moon dasha, you will have relatively easily. Yes, that's how benefics behave. They give you things easily. Malefics don't give you things easily. You have to work for it. You have to pay a heavy price. Okay. That is how you analyze. Not just blindly saying Saturn delays, but he never denies. He may never delay. He may delay, or even he may deny. All right. So it depends on the dashas and that event and the other houses linked with that particular house. So for example, for 7th house, the 2nd and 11th. For childbirth, 5th house, but 2nd, 9th and 11th. And it depends on the sign also. And if you are talking of career, you have to check the Dashamsha chart. And for Navamsha, you can see for marriage. Okay. So therefore, don't jump into blind conclusions. Okay, so analyze the horoscope in detail and you see where the flow of the horoscope is. That will tell you what Saturn is going to do. All right, that will be all from my side. If you're new to the channel, then please subscribe to it below. And if you want a consultation from me, you can go to my website down below. God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him.